It's sunny outside. What better moment to clean the drains, sunroof drains, infamous ones that will get your car wet inside under the carpet, usually won't see. It's very, very easy to do, very quick, and I do recommend you do it at least once every summer, but I would recommend you do it 2-3 times. I'll explain at the end of the video why. This is what I use. It's a tube, plastic tube. Inside diameter, I think it's 1/4 inch, and I think when you buy it from the stores, this is how they say this is 1/4 inch tube. So usually they specify the inside diameter. Outside is 3/8, so you get them on any hardware store. And I have a water hose, garden hose. You notice these are fairly standard, has a ways like a straight jet like this. Let me just show you. So this is what I'm going to use, and what I found is that this size of tube, 1/4 inch inside, fits very nicely on this nozzle. So it's just fitting there. It almost stays by itself, but you may want to just keep it with your hand too. Once you get in there, the other end, if you see it, that's the hole for the drains. It's right here in the corner, and this 3/8 outside diameter fits perfectly in there. It's just right. It kind of slides in there, so it's perfect actually. So we'll do this for this side, and then repeat for the front side. We also have rear ones, but they are really impossible to reach, so front ones is just enough. So just give it a jet. And you may want to try first slow jet, a weak jet, because if your drain is clogged, it will just spray it out. So just start with a slow jet. But I know mines are already unclogged and are clear, so we should be see it leak it right there. The exit hole is somewhere under the car. Once you know it's clear, just give it a good jet. So you put some pressure on it, and 2-3 seconds should be fine. But again, start slowly, because you never know what's how clogged is that thing, and you don't want it to leak inside the car somehow. And then just simply repeat the other side, and you are good to go. This is really easy to do, takes a few seconds, and let me just explain why it's so important. Actually, basically, people may think that this gets clogged only if you have leaves or leaves debris and stuff like that, but that's really not true. This gets clogged most of the time because of dust inside the cities. Like I say in another video, when you see your, it's raining and you see a lot of dust on the windows, that's what's clogging these drains. So don't wait thinking you never open the sunroof, or maybe you never leave it under the trees. Don't wait for that to check the drains. Check them anyway. You notice, you see this dust here right on the tray. This dust is from rain, and this is, it looks fine, but in time, this is what clogs these drains, because they are really tiny tubes, especially an S60 V70. XC90 has larger one, so maybe less troubles with those cars. But again, don't wait and check it right away. Usually when you buy the car used, these seals are 10-15 years old. They are not perfectly sealing any longer. If you just maybe when it's raining, just get inside the garage, open the sunroof, you'll notice there's water inside the trays. That's because it's kind of leaking very slowly, and that dust gets inside as well. So this is my recommendation. If you don't believe it, well, I cannot do more than that. And why is really that important? You know what happens most of the times, people notice, sorry for the carpets, it's I actually do need to remove them and clean them up. Most of the time what people will notice is wet carpets, but even worse is that these carpets are rubberized, and usually water is trapped underneath and the top stays dry, so they don't, people won't even notice it's really, really wet and moist. underneath, they would basically notice when it starts really to smell after a few years sitting there. But that's not the worst part. Basically what you have to do, and check the at the very end of this video, I'll put a few links that may help you what to do with that. What you have to do is remove the carpets from the car. That's not an easy or a quick job. But really what's worse than that, when it's getting clogged here, there is a tray right there, and this tray fills with water when it's raining and then overflows, and it's wetting this upper trim, the roof trim. But even worse than that, it will leak past this trim. Usually it will leak like that, it will just pass here and leak through the A pillar on either side, depends how the car stays parked. But what's the problem here? What you have here is the side curtain, is the airbag. It's rolled like that in here. I'm not sure I can show it. No, not now, but it's really rolled like this, and it ends somewhere here, but it's still attached here. The problem when the sunroof drains get blocked, the water flows right on the airbag, right? It got the curtain here completely wet, and it will stay like this for months or even for years. And to top it up, it's sometimes depends on your area, you will get in winter time that water will freeze on the curtain airbag. So imagine the airbag, it's wet with water, it's freezing. Ice has this thing that's expanding, and it will damage the curtain airbag material. So you got a really nice problem there, if I can say so. It's just will it possibly damage the curtain airbag, and it's not the explosive part of it, because that's sealed inside a cylinder. It's really a material, and I'm not sure how it's going to deploy if you need it in the crash. Is it going to work properly or not? So that's, I think when I did check mine, I noticed that the side curtain airbag on this side was different color than on the driver's side, and I believe that this car had a previous problem and perhaps Volvo already replaced the airbag because it was wet. That's just a supposition, I'm not sure about it. But really, that's why it's really important to check your drain holes. And by the way, when you replace or try to remove this trim to check your airbag, check at the end of this video, there's another important thing, is that there's a safety clip here. You really need to remove it properly and to place it back properly to keep this part secure here when the airbag deploys. But just check at the end of this video, I'll put a few good informations, good few links. Yes, I think I went through everything, but again, check that drain holes, check, make sure it doesn't have a problem. And also, if you happen to find the airbag here wet, if you want to keep it, you have to keep it also exposed. So keep this guy off, maybe bent a little bit the trim here. So keep the airbag exposed, because it will take several weeks in summertime to dry up if you want to keep it. All right, so this is it, guys. These are for the front, two front drains. There's also two rear one. I think it's less important because the car will work with the front ones draining properly. But yeah, all the way from 2001, 2009, these cars have this problem. It's very, very common. Don't wait to check it. And thanks for watching.